Hey kids, welcome back to Clean Slate Farm. Today we're going to be installing nukes. We had some hives dive over the winter and I called my beekeeper pal and he supplied us with a couple of nukes. So we're going to go through the process of installing nukes. Okay, for someone who hasn't done this before, let me explain what this is going to what's going to happen here. I've got the bottom box here is going to be the brood chamber. There are five frames in there. I've got three wax frames and then two full of honey. What's going to happen is when I open this up, I'm going to put some brush in front of the nuke. The bees will reorient themselves, and I'll come back in a couple of hours and I'll take the frames out of this and into this. This has the queen, about 3 pounds or so of bees, some larvae, and some honey in there. So that will set this going. Once I put this back in here, and then I'll take this upper chamber and we'll put it on here, a super on here. So I'm going to have the inner cover, outer cover. I've got an entrance reducer. I don't know if I'll use that or not, but we'll see how that goes. It's kind of warm out today. Now I'm going to lift this little tab. When I do that, they're liable to come flying out like crazy. So I'll just pick that up a little bit like that and put this up in here because the entrance is going to flip up and then they're going to be able to come out. And they'll come out the sides, and there they come. What a beautiful sight.
So we're going to start installing the second nuke. And what I want to do is just make sure everything is set up properly. Everything's in place. Get my little branch there. Set that off to the side. We're going to bring the super around, or the box around, and get that ready and get in place and drop a frame. Clean the frame off because now I've got it all covered in stones. But I want that nice and tidy. Get any dirt and things off of that. Put it back in. Adjust everything a little bit. Now we're ready for the nuke. I'm gonna put that on top just like I did on hive one. Come around front and put the branch in there. First I'll get everything set up for when I take the frames out. I'm just going to make an adjustment to the bottom box there, the brood chamber, and then I'll come around front and we'll start by putting the branch in front so they have a chance to orient as they come out of the super or out of the nuke. And that's pretty much it. You just have to remember to take your time, be calm, always be calm working around the bees. I found that if you're rattled, they're rattled. So just slow down and take your time. This second branch didn't want to stay in place, so get rid of it. In a minute, you're going to hear the bees as it opens up. I'll be quiet. Box opened up, or the entrance opened up, and the bees started coming out. Now, admire your handiwork.
So we might get some drift from the hives, this one and this one, where the nukes might go into those two hives. Chances are they won't, might get a little bit, but what's going to happen is they're going to smell the pheromone of their queen, and that's why I've got a box in between, a hive in between, so there's enough separation there. But they'll smell the pheromones from their queen. If they don't smell it in here, they'll drift their way back to there, or they should. So I moved the nuke over a little bit, but you can see down in there kind of. They're already starting to check out the new comb, or the old comb there, and honey, so they'll see that source. That's a good thing. They're checking out their new home. So it's been about an hour and a half, 2 hours. I just took the branch out of that. We'll take the branch out of the other one there. They seem to be acclimating quite well. There's bees down inside, and they're crawling around on the comb, so I think we're ready to go. So I'm just going to move these things, get these out of the way here. And I'm going to take this and put it down here, and I can feel that box is vibrating like crazy in there. And if we'll open this, and I'm not sure how they're going to take to me opening that. I haven't got my gloves on. They seem to be pretty docile, but we'll see what happens when we open this up. Wow, they're building comb up on top of that already, so we're just going to brush them away. And these pins, just to hold things in place, so we're going to move that. Oops. Come on, go away, little bee. The biggest cluster is down in here, as you can see. So let's see how this goes with no gloves. Break that loose. And I'm going to try to put these in the hive the same way I'm taking them out of Nuke. Should be a little easier now. And I want to be careful that I don't drop the queen or lose the queen in there somewhere or squish the queen. So we'll break all those apart first. And now we'll take them out. Look at the comb they've built on the bottom already. So I think what I want to do is scrape that comb off. I don't want that on there. And we're going to squish some bees, so. If you look down here, that's drone. This is all worker bee. All worker bee on that side. So there's going to be a lot of bees in this thing. So the queen might be on this board here somewhere. There she is. Nope, that's not her. Well, let's get this scraped off first. And the way I slide the box on kind of brushes the bees out of the way so they don't get squished. You have to remember, it's going to be inevitable that you smash bees. Inner cover, and a rock to hold it in place. So that's hive number one. Everything seems to have gone well there, and now we're going to do hive number two. Now let's take a closer look here. This is a neat pattern. It's what the bees do when they build their brood. The brood goes inside here, and then they put honey and nectar around the outside. It's kind of like a half moon shape, I guess. So you can see all the brood down in there. Same thing on this side, less pronounced, but brood here and honey on the outside. So when they need the feed, they can go right outside here and get their honey. Don't see a queen anywhere, but Eric assures me there's a queen in there. And Eric's a pretty good guy, so we're going to believe him. Now, that's not to say that he marked the queens, though. Yep, there she is, right here. Yep. See her? Crawling around. There we go. Okay, close her up. the bumbling beekeeper. No entrance hole. I got it on backwards. So don't do everything I do. So there you have it. That's installing a nuke into a hive, and a nuke is short again for a nucleus colony, and we went pretty smooth doing that. The bees were pretty docile. Just the one thing to keep in mind is just take your time with it. Make sure you put something in front of the nuke when you open it up so they have a chance to orient to where they are, and you'll be fine. When you open the nuke to transfer everything over, work slow and deliberate. I got stung once, which I kind of expected to get stung more than that. But hey, it's only a bee sting. It doesn't kill you. At least most people. Hey, thanks for watching Clean Slate Farm. I'll put a link below into more of our beekeeping videos, and also a link to our Amazon affiliate page. It helps support us here at Clean Slate Farm. If you purchase through that link, we get a small commission, and it's greatly appreciated. So that's all for Clean Slate Farm and beekeeping for today. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.